Good evening. Well, first up tonight, it's been a chaotic 24 hours of weather across Queensland with heatwave conditions giving way to damaging storms and torrential downpours this afternoon. Residents in Logan have spent the day cleaning up after they were smashed by a system which tore apart homes and knocked out power for tens of thousands of people.
A harsh reminder of the fury still left in our storm season. Logan residents huddled inside as the roofs over their heads peeled back.
All the water just flooding in. That's how I knew, because I got wet, because I was having a little power nap.
His kip ended abruptly by the waking realisation his family's home and cars were torn to pieces.
So it's really damaged and all the water is already inside, already leaking down the ceilings and that, so I don't think it's livable at the moment.
A couple of doors up, Jo's house was struck by the tin from her neighbour's roofs.
It was terrifying. The window just shattered and everything was coming through. We had hail come through the window. You just didn't know what to do. It was a case of wait and let it happen.
And while it did happen, briefly, lasting less than half an hour, it left a full day of cleaning up for council crews and SES teams.
Probably about 48 of them were for trees that had come down and landed on top of people's roofs. Unfortunately, there were six houses that did actually lose their entire roof.
The Bureau confirms a tornado formed as the system rolled across Logan and Browns Plains. Residents say the wind quickly changed direction and threw around anything that wasn't firmly bolted down.
We'll get the power on and get the streets cleaned up. That's the biggest challenge now, but you know, Woodridge is a tough community. We've taken a bit of a knock, but we're going to bounce back from this.
Falling trees took out power lines, leaving almost 30,000 people sweltering through the night without power, including a nearby aged care facility.
Respond to quite a number of our older population. Those incidents involve people that have collapsed in the street, felt dizzy or disorientated at home.
The feels like temperature today continued to push towards 40 in some areas.
If you've got a loved one or a dear friend, please check in on them. Please make sure that they are well hydrated and cool.
It was tough going for those feeding the shredders. Of course, in typical Queensland style, as soon as those storms dissipated, back came this oppressive heat and humidity. And for those who've been working all day, there's a few ingenious strategies being employed to not only keep the boys cool, but also keep the ants off their backs.
February is a typically humid month, but this is well above average even for February. Conditions more typically you'd see in Darwin at this time of year.
Forecasters say relief is on the horizon with a drop of 10 degrees tomorrow. Chris Campy for 10 News First.
Well, as expected, there have been more storms moving across the southeast. Our reporter Jacob Chico is following developments for us tonight. Jacob, are they packing as much punch as we saw yesterday?
Yeah, we are going to see intense rainfall from northern New South Wales to large parts of the southeast. But as for the extreme wind gusts we saw yesterday, the Bureau says it won't be as severe, which is really good news. Right now, this is a bit of a reprieve. It wasn't long ago we started to see those showers roll in. This won't be for long, though. The Bureau says in the next hour or so, we will see a return of those intense showers because there are more storms forming. And the Gold Coast and Brisbane can expect most of it. It will be around 100 millimetres in those areas overnight. The southeast will cop the fair share of this system before it moves to the west around central parts of Queensland and up further north over the coming days. Now, we know around 30,000 homes yesterday experienced a power outage. That number is very different right now. There are around 5,500 homes without power, and the majority of those are again in the Woodridge area. Energex says the situation will continue to change, and tonight it's very important people have their phones, their tablets and their laptops charged to be able to keep up to date with these alerts and these warnings as it changes. Now, Hugh, with these weather warnings comes the risk of flash flooding. Drivers are being told to take extreme care this afternoon on the drive home and into tomorrow as well.
Good advice. Thank you for the update, Jacob. Well, let's bring in our weather expert, Josh Holt, now. Josh, everyone wants a little bit of relief. When's it coming?
Yeah, that's the big question on everyone's lips. It's been absolutely atrocious over the past couple of days, Hugh, with those very warm temperatures, but also those high levels of humidity. In fact, we hit tops of 36 degrees in Brisbane today, but the feel like temperature, as Chris mentioned in his package, up around that 39, 40 degree mark. You can see here those temperatures rising quickly today, but then cooling as that area of cloud, shower and thunderstorm activity began to push across areas of southeast Queensland. This is the good news. Our trough of low pressure, which is helping to cause those showers and storms, will push further northward over the next 24 hours. Look what happens in behind it. You get that southerly wind change and a southerly air mass pushing into southeast Queensland. That will alleviate the atmosphere from those very, very hot temperatures we've been experiencing over the past couple of days. So check out Thursday. 27 degrees on the forecast with some rain on the way. 25 degrees, very mild on Friday with a shower or two, and much the same into the weekend. And for Ipswich, after seeing that heat again today, 27 degrees tomorrow, so much cooler, 25 again on Friday, and followed by temperatures in the mid-20s right through the weekend. So some much better weather on the way, Hugh.
Thank heaven, as they say, Josh. Thank you.